120 minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield. With me right now are Jill, Vivian, and Kate of Luscious Jackson. They have a new album out called Fever In, Fever Out. And but Gabby's missing today. So can you let everybody know why? What happened to Gabby today?
It's kind of a tragic tale.
Well, she's fine, first of all.
Right.
You don't want to worry anybody. But we were driving our tour bus up from Nashville in order to get to David Letterman the other day. And we had a flat. So Gabby went out to change the tire, and she was pumping up the jack, and she threw out her back.
While she was changing the tire?
Yeah.
She thinks she's a guy.
What's up with the rubber?
Hey, I know a lot of girls who can change tires really well.
Yeah, that's good. Why didn't you let somebody else do it?
She insisted,
Yeah.
Gabby insisted on changing the tire, and
like that.
She's just learning how to do it. So.
She's a grease monkey.
She's actually having control, too, of what's going on.
You'd think she'd try and practice on smaller cars.
Yeah. A bus is pretty tough to deal with.
Yeah.
Because you never know.
She wanted to start at the top.
The jack slips out, though, you know.
It wasn't the best jack, either.
Yeah.
So,
just in case we ever get invited on, you know, the Dream Chaser, which is the Judd's bus, you know, I think Gabby wants to be sure that she can be helpful in whatever way might be necessary.
Oh, that'll be excellent. That's good to know.
Yeah. So she's recovering right now, the back injury.
Okay, well, she's at least watching, so it's important.
Yeah. She's went to the chiropractor and acupuncture, the whole thing.
Yeah. Well, that's good to hear.
Yeah.
And Naked Eye is the new video and the single from the album. Tell me a bit about the video itself. Which director's films are you doing like a spoof on? What is it influenced by the video itself?
I guess most notably Alphaville.
Right.
And what else? We kind of had talked about the Tati, Jacques Tati, who did all these movies that are really amazing. They're sort of incredible little pieces of art direction. I don't know how else to describe it. They're really great.
Jacques Tati did these
very funny
films, I guess in the 60s, right?
Yeah.
Where he plays, the one we used was you can pronounce it.
Mon oncle.
And he plays Daffy Uncle, who lives in the old-fashioned part of town, which is, in France, you know, it looks very medieval.
Everybody's playing accordions.
And like pushing carts of fruit. And then he's the uncle. And then his brother lives in this incredibly futuristic world where the fountain, you open the gate and the fountain goes on and everything's like automatic. And it's like
totally modern.
Yeah, how they would have imagined the future back in the 60s.
And that's always interesting to see the way that they move ahead to 1997, like it's this big.
That style. The futuristic style was what we wanted to capture, so we
retro future.
We called it retro future, how they viewed the future.
Yeah, and it worked
back
very well.
Back then. Yeah.
Let's check out that video right now. We're going to play the video for Naked Eye. It's from the album Fever In, Fever Out. Right now, here's Luscious Jackson on 120 Minutes. Debut album, Who Can You Trust? That's the English band Morcheeba with Trigger Hippie here on 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield. I'm here with Vivian, Kate, and Jill of Luscious Jackson. And they have a new album out called Fever In, Fever Out, which is co-produced by Daniel Lanois, who has a studio in New Orleans, and a lot of people have recorded there. I mean, he's worked with U2 and Peter Gabriel, but he's recently had Better Than Ezra, who were guests a few weeks back. They're around the same time you were, from what I understand, right?
That's right, and we were having such a great time at the studio, which is absolutely beautiful, that we asked Better Than Ezra to postpone their recording. We wrote them a letter that was...
We begged. Basically.
And we received...
Didn't work.
A fax back that said, sorry, and had all these little hearts and kisses, like, making fun of us, because we tried to be really nice.
And, maybe they weren't making fun. Maybe they were just...
No, they were making fun of us.
Well, I think what happened is that we originally pretty much wanted to record in New York because we're from New York and we're most comfortable there. And so at some point, Dan Lanois said, well, why don't we just book a couple of weeks in New Orleans and just check it out? And, you know, once we got there, we realized how incredible it was and we wanted to stay forever. But, you know, that just doesn't work that way.
It's a gigantic mansion.
But we did learn that, you know, New York is not the only place. There are other places out there, too.
But there's very few other places.
But New Orleans is one of them. His Kingsway, studio, is like paradise.
Like stepping back in time into, like, another very decadent, luxurious era. They've decorated the place with antiques, and it's just got a whole vibe to it that's, like, very inspirational. So
did it feel real natural for you to record that? It was good.
Once we got used to having a lot of space, you know, as New Yorkers, we're used to, like, sardine, you know, can apartments. So once we got used to that, it was really great, yeah.
It was also nice to have the pedestrian aspect, which is something, as New Yorkers, we are we rely upon our feet more because we don't drive and anything. So New Orleans was perfect for that.
Same kind of thing in the French Quarter,
you
right?
You can walk around, yeah.
All people do is walk around and go wild there, right?
Yeah.
We'll be talking more with Luscious Jackson when we come back. First, here's a look at the top 10 singles on alternative radio this week. Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm here with Luscious Jackson. I'm your host, Matt Pinfield. And this album, Fever In, Fever Out, there's less sampling. It's more instrumentation itself. I mean, if you look back on In Search of Manny, your first EP, which was an excellent one, by the way, there was a lot of sampling going on. And even moving throughout, you've moved away. And does that have a lot to do with the fact that you've done a lot more touring recently? I know that you were playing, doing all your stuff on stage when you toured with R.E.M., you're really well received as well. What would you say?
Yes.
we toured for about 2 years on Natural Ingredients.
Yeah.
And we started on Lollapalooza, and pretty much, you know, we came home a lot, but we didn't stop for about a year and a half to 2 years. And in that time, we really improved as a group, you know, playing together. And on this record, we wanted to explore that. And, you know, sampling is great, and it's so much fun. And so is live.
Yeah.
So it was just really fun for us to have Daniel work with us, who's such an expert, you know, at getting really great sounds. And he actually brought in so much vintage equipment that, you know, we love samples because they sound old. And that people used to use different recording techniques. And, you know, a lot of engineers don't know how to get that great sound. So Dan brings in Neve boards and old mics. And we were able to get sounds we loved today. You know, we didn't have to kind of shop in the past to get tube sounds and
which a lot of people do.
Non-digital sounds, you know, things like that. So.
Yeah. And you had Emmy Lou Harris come in and sing back out on two tracks and DF of Brand New Heavies.
Right.
Friends, really friends or They're, people you admired?
Emmy Lou's friends with Dan, and he produced her last record, Wrecking Ball.
Right.
And he invited her to come in when we were recording and just maybe she'll sing some backups. And we're like, right on, you know.
Yeah.
And same with India. She lives down in New Orleans and we had met her before years ago, and she had always expressed interest in working with us. Mm-hmm. So it worked out, and hopefully there'll be more in the future.
That's good, because they really sound good on there as well. Right now it's the New York band Fountains of Wayne, who are also New Jersey, too. Let's give them a little credit from Wayne, where they got the name. And the first clip off of their self-titled album is for a song called Radiation Vibe. Titled debut album, that's Butter 08 with Butter of 69 here on 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield, and I'm here with Luscious Jackson. And speaking of Butter 08 and Russell Simmons, who's, of course, drums in John Spencer Blues Explosion, another fellow New York band, and is playing drums and singing there, he also remixed Naked Eye for you as well on the EP, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's a very busy man.
Good drummer, too.
Yeah, Russell remixed something for us last time, and he did such a good job on a song called Here that we hired him again. And he did a really nice job remixing Naked Eye.
Now, you're good friends. Did you want to say you want to tell me
something?
Yeah,
that video that everybody just saw was filmed on my street early one morning. And, you know, I already knew all the music. And I sort of woke up and I was like, God, it's a loud Butter 08 blasting, you know, through downtown Manhattan. And I went out and there they were on a Lazy Susan all spinning around, getting really ill, and
the one looking
being
up
filmed,
in the air,
and then
shot.
And then Evan Bernard, the director, was running around, you know, in the opposite direction, and it was kind of fun. Hung out for a couple of hours,
and right. And then I was walking uptown on Thompson Street, and there was the crew. The same day, I ran into them, and then also you.
Well, I ran to Evan before scouting locations, so.
See, New York is a tiny village.
Yes,
it is.
Everybody knows everybody.
And you have a lot of good friends in those bands. I mean, obviously. Butter 08 are on your label, Grand Royal,
right.
Which is a label, that is the Beastie Boys label. And we'll actually get back to talking about that in just a minute. Yeah. Stick around because we've got more to talk about with Luscious Jackson. And right after the break, we're going to play a video from their album, Natural Ingredients. So stay with us.
I don't need to know. Not semi-automatic sisters, I might be strong, but don't call me mister. Playing with the status quo of the soul. Enjoy Babylon.
Yeah.
Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield. I've been talking with Luscious Jackson. And I'm here with Vivian, Kate, and Jill. Gabby's missing, but you'll get to see her on tour sometime soon,
right?
Did
you notice our good posture over here?
Very good posture.
It's hard when you sit on these cases.
Yeah. These are made for schlumping.
Yeah, they really are. I'm always cleaning up.
I was made for schlumping you, baby.
Okay. Now, besides the side project that you've done, Vivian and Jill, with Co-Stars, which is the Classics with a K-E-P.
And LP.
It's an LP, I guess you want to call it.
Ten songs.
Yeah, so it is, you're right. But
it's squeezed into the LP.
LP mode. Yeah. But it's a great duet you do with the guys from Ween, Don't Know Why, which is just, it's a really soulful song. And I mean, you've done, like I said, we talk about In Search of Manny and Natural Ingredients. And let's talk a bit about the fact of how you got hooked up with Grand Royal in the first place. And were you friends with Mike Dean, the guys at the label? Did they discover you? Because if you look at, in the past, a lot of the influences seem to be grown up in New York, drawing from the same places, at least originally, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Where there's some samples, there's some R&B, there's some funk, you know what I mean? There's some soul, there's a little bit of rap, there's a little bit of everything in there. So.
Yeah, well, we, just as you said, we grew up in New York and went to see tons of music.
Yeah.
We were, young teenagers going out to all kinds of nightclubs. And in that time, we met Mike and Adam and Adam. It was kind of, we were just a big group of friends. And when they became giant rap stars, we kind of lost contact. And Kate was actually the drummer on the first record, Pollywog Stew.
Mm-hmm. And
Cookie Puss. Yeah.
Right. Well, for Great EP, of course.
Of course.
Cookie Opus.
Fabulous one.
Yeah.
And so we already knew them, and then a friend of ours passed away, David Skilkin, and I gave Mike at the funeral, who I hadn't seen for years. Actually, not at the funeral. A little bit later, a couple days later, I gave him the tape. And that's how it all started. We made the first record on Grand Royal.
Yeah, which is an In Search of Manny EP, which is still worth going out and checking out. Sounds like Daughters of the Chaos and Let Yourself Get Down. And the new one is definitely out, and it's called Fever In, Fever Out. I want to thank you for coming by, and it was really good to have you here.
Thank you.
I hope she feels better.
Oh, we will.
And we'll see you again soon on tour as well. And right now we're going to play a video from Luscious Jackson's Natural Ingredients album for the song called City Song. Take care.